Hey, my name is Gala, and today I continue to talk about blending data sources in Google Data Studio. I created two tested tables in Google Sheets. It is a Google Ads and Facebook Ads data. Where we have date, campaign, cost, impressions, clicks and conversions. The same fields we have for Facebook, and I already connected these two tables to Google Data Studio. If we go to resources, manage edit data sources, you can see that we have Google Ads and Facebook Ads. When I connected it, I changed the name. I keep only short name, and I change cost from number to currency, because cost it is usually a currency, so I change it to euro. Then I created two tables, Google Ads table and Facebook Ads table, where we can see our data. You don't need to do it, it is just to show you which data do we have in these tables. I think it will be easier if we remove this campaign and this campaign. And we do sort by date, descending, yes, perfect. And here is the same, sort by date, descending. What we can see here, we can see that both tables, they have four rows. Here we have 9, 6, 5, and 4, and here we have 7, 6, 5, and 4 focused. It is important because we can see different types of joins based on this data. Let's start from how can we create blended data. We have two options how to do it. We have resources, manage blends, and we can click to add blend, and we can start from the scratch. And in this case, we can select, okay, let's start from Google Ads. Let's do dimension. I will select date. Metrics, I would select only cost. And date range, date auto. Or we can create custom and we can add filter. These tools are used often for some Google Analytics reports, and it could be really useful, this filter option. Then we add another table, and it will be Facebook Ads. And we can add another table, or another, and maximum that we can add, it is 5 tables. Usually it is enough, but in some cases it's not. But anyway, Google allows us add only 5 tables here. And here we should select some dimensions. We should select and metrics. I will select the same as we have there. And data range, yes, I will select here as well, because we will try to use different blends types. And here in configure join, we can click here. And here we have 5 types of joins that we observe in previous video. And here we can select type of join, and we can select fields based on which field we will join. So for example, in our case, it is a date, and it is a really common case for marketing and sales data. When we take date and try to find the same information from another table for the same date. Actually, it could be, we don't have campaign here because we need to edit as a dimension first. So you see, we have in dimension, we have only date, and here we have only date. If we add here campaign and add here campaign, we can see that cost. Yeah, I don't want to join data by cost. We can have campaigns here, and we can join data using date and campaign, or we can use only campaigns if prefer, and if we don't care about dates and just want to see the common data from campaign. Then we can add the name of our new data source. It is not data source name, it is data blending data source name. It will be more accurate. Then we can see all fields that we have. And when I choose it, we can save. Oh, sorry, I didn't. Okay, date, save. And now we can save it. And what else would I would like to put your attention here? As you see, we have cost field here and cost field here. And in the final table, we will have cost table 1, cost table 2. It is not easy to use. So what I do in Metrix, I click to edit and Google adds Google cost. I rename the field Google cost and rename this field Facebook cost. And you see in the final table, we will have Facebook cost and Google cost. And when we rename it, it's easier to use in a final table. Then we can click save and use this blended data source. I will close it because I already created some and show, okay, this card changes. And another way to create blend, it is click to existing table and we will see setup and below the data source, we have the blend data button. We can click here. And in this case, we already will have on the left table, we already will have all fields that we have in a real table. And it is, yeah, it is nice. And already we have something pressed up. So that is it for this video. And in next video, we will see difference between different types of joins. Thank you and bye.